Okay, so today we have an 06 Envoy SLT, and it's got about 35,000 miles on it. We're going to change the fluid in the rear differential, which has limited slip lubricant and already added to the fluid because it's got a limited slip rear. So the easiest way to get started on this deal is, I find, is to get it up on ramps like this. You'll find this is going to be so much easier if you do this. And then bring down the spare tire and get that out of the way. And after you do that, what you're going to see, let me get this brightness up so we can see everything underneath here, is there's the rear differential. And rear differential cover has 10 bolts on it. They're 13 millimeter. And what we're going to end up doing is taking all the bolts off but the top one, which is this one up here. But before you even get started with the bolts, the first thing you want to do that you can break the bolt loose for the fill hole. Now, that is accomplished pretty easily. And hopefully you don't have to do a lot of muscling, which I didn't, is you take a here we go. Brightness up a little too high here. There we go. Take a 3/8 inch drive extension and then put a ratchet handle on it, as so. And when you go up here on the passenger side of the pumpkin, and this is on the opposite side from the cover over here. Let's hope I can keep this in focus. This will go right into here, like that. And you can take and loosen it. If you loosen it, if you want to check the level, let me grab, I was just reaching over to grab this. You get a pipe cleaner. And you stick the pipe cleaner in a little bit, pull it out and see if it's wet. If it's wet, it means it's the fluid level's up near the top here. Mine actually started dripping out as soon as I took started to take the bolt out, which wasn't that difficult at all. So I put this plug bolt, whatever you want to call it, back in for now. You see it's a little wet there. And I'll continue the video after I've removed the bolts from the differential cover and come back. I'll also go grab a drain pan to don't let all the fluid dump out into. The way this camera just likes to darken everything. And I'll be right back. So I've taken out all 9 bolts except the 10th one, which is holding the top cover on. And as soon as I took out the bolt, last bolt on the bottom, I didn't even have to pull on this cover. It just kind of came loose. So there we are. It's sitting there and it's draining out. I used an air ratchet with the 13 millimeter on it, and it had no trouble whatsoever. I just kind of gave it a couple starting cranks there, and then it just took off from that point on. So at this point, the fluid's draining out here. Pull this out a little bit more. Let me see what I can do here about trying to prop it up in such a position that you can catch this. Maybe a couple gloves. Hold on. Sorry about that. Okay, here's the cover. Right. So I take and remove the cover here. Loosen this bolt a little bit more. pull this out, and here comes the cover, and here comes the gasket. The original GM gasket, and the reason and the way you can tell, you can see that it's got it's like a rubber ridged reinforced gasket, and it's not paper, and I have a matching one ready to go. And if you can take a look here, let me see if I can get you a good picture here. Oh, that's great. Yes, turn that up a little bit. We're going to use this pipe cleaner and show you the filings that have been accumulating on the magnet. Oh my God. It's really not too bad, but they're definitely there. Yeah, see all that? That's filings. So I'm going to take a rag, wipe that all out. I'm going to wipe the cover off real good. Excuse me. And maybe wipe a little bit of the inside out here a little bit. Make sure I get the rest of this out. And then just reassemble it. That's pretty much it. We'll be back in a little bit after I get the cover back on and we move into the fill process. All right, well, we pretty much have the all the cover wiped out pretty well, and cleaned up around the perimeter where the bolts go. Didn't need to scrape anything. It's perfectly clean. If you want to look inside looks pretty damn good. Gears look at perfect shape. Nothing odd hanging around, nothing laying in the bottom. So I think we're pretty much set to put everything back in and put the cover on and put the bolts on. So we'll pick up the video as soon as I do that. One thing I wanted to make note before you go to put this gasket back on. It's almost symmetrical once you get it properly aligned, but I want to make sure that you know that this was the hole up here, like this hole, that was the top. There's a last bolt that I left sitting in to hold the cover from falling down. But make a note that you see this little flag piece sticking out. When this goes back in, it goes back in like this at the top, with that flag in the lower left-hand corner. Just like that. So here's the new one, just like it. The flag in the lower left-hand corner, right in to there. So, I'll be right back. All right, I'm now ready to get the fluid back into the, or gear oil that is, back into the rear. I just wanted to pump out a little bit so you could see how clear this liquid is. It's not dark like what I just took out, but it's pretty clear. And it won't stay that way that long, but but that's exactly what we need to do. But anyway, I've taken out the drain plug, fill plug, I mean. It's not a drain plug. There is no drain plug. That's a fill plug. So I've taken that out, putting that back, and now we're going to pump the new stuff back in. This pump is available, by the way, from Amazon. Really inexpensive, and it can be used over and over again. And it can be, and it has two different types of straw inserts in the bottom. So if you got a short container like this, or you got a slightly taller one, like the taller bottle that's round, it'll fit that in them too. So this is a real handy saver and makes a minimal mess. All right, so I'll be back in a minute. Just put that in. So we've filled the case up and started to spill out. So I put the plug back in, and this is now the last step. just to screw this, the plug back in place, and we're all done. And that's it for the whole entire job. And basically this whole thing can be done within an hour. New gasket all in place, it's all dry. I will wipe some extras off, but for the most part it's dry, except where I splattered it. But it did take all two full bottles of this AC Delco LS, which means limited slip gear oil. So beware. Specs say just short of 2 quarts, but it took it all. I mean, all that's basically left is the bottle's empty, and there's this little tiny bit left inside the hose that pumps it in. So I would call that 2 full quarts. That's it for the video for today. Good luck. It's not that hard.